Oh, God is not a man that he should lie, nor the Son of Man that he should repent. Oh, hath he said and shall he not do it? Or hath he spoken and shall he not make it good? Behold, I have received commandments to bless, and he had blessed, and I cannot reverse it. Oh, God is not a man that he should lie, nor the Son of Man that he shall repent. Now listen to me. This is in Numbers chapter 23, verse 19, and it's a promise to God for you, my dear brothers and sisters. I know some of you have been in quarantine, and thank God none of us have died. As far as I know, all of my loved ones and friends have been some folks that died that I know have died, but I'm sorry for them. But thank God for the church in Romania. Nobody has died. We have four of the churches we've planted. We had to shut some of them down for a little bit, but we've made provisions. And by your prayers and support, we've been able to take food out to them. We're going to show you some pictures as we go out to the gypsy villages where we work at, where we planted churches. When I say a church, I don't mean a building with a steeple and all fine glass in it. I'm talking about a body of people. Now, we do have some church buildings. We built one. We built a school building for a children's school there and after school for the children. And we're going to show you that too. So right now I'm going to bring Bianca in. She's Moses' wife, Brother Moses. And we're going to show you some of the food we took out to them. And thank you so very much. You are there in America that pray for us and take care of us and by prayer. And you take care of us financially. And by, you know, every year this time of year I come to the States. And half of my support I get when I go around all the different churches, and people give me gifts to bring back, and we start putting it into the work of the Lord here. But some of you have been so faithful, and I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for giving. You know things are as tight and things are happening and nobody can get around and move, but you still remember the work of the Lord. That's because you're in it with me. We're co-laborers together. And I want to thank you with all of my heart for it. Now, here comes Bianca in just a moment. Hello, everyone. This is Brother Martin Millett with Romania Mission, and I'm so glad to have Sister Bianca Crivisin and her husband with us today. He's taking the film, and you'll see him in some of the films as we go out to the gypsy villages to show you what's going on. And now let me introduce you or bring Sister Bianca to you.
I'm so happy to be back, Brother Amen. Martin. We're Amen. So happy that we are here and are filming again.
Yes.
And we get to talk again to you, our people, yeah. and our brothers and sisters.
It's been 4 months.
In Christ, yes. It's been 4 months since we've been self-isolating yeah. and in quarantine. It's been quite hard, yeah. if not very hard for yeah. us. But we're so happy to be back, and we have some good news, and we can't wait to share them with you.
Yeah, you know, although we've been in quarantine for months, we've still been going out to the villages, taking food, contact, having baptisms. So it hasn't been, the work hadn't shut down. We just had to be very careful with the mask and our hands, and as you know. So as we go out to the villages, I want to show you some of the families that Bianca speaks about a lot about Danutz, the little Danutz. Now, he's big now, isn't he?
He's big now, yeah. He's so cute. He's chubby. He's the only word that I can describe him
That's
with.
Good, Nick. That's
but
good
I'm so happy because even he lives in poor conditions, yeah. I'm happy that he's a healthy baby. And that's amazing. Yeah.
You know, first we should tell him about you and Moise going out with a van. You and Moses going out with a van. And how many packages did you take with food?
We had 130 packages.
You know what, Bianca? Let's just show them the food.
Yeah,
this is better. A store called Selgros. I don't know if you can see it from the camera.
Yeah.
But this is kind of like a store. It's like Sam's. You know, you have to buy three or four at a time. And we bought them some oil.
Okay? Sunflower oil.
Sunflower oil. And I'll bring the stuff and you can tell them what it is. Here it is.
There is some corn flour here.
Let me put this up here.
Because we like polenta very much here and we make it very often. And because people are poor, it's easier for them to make polenta than buy bread. There is also rice.
Now that this the malai is kind of like what you use to make cornbread with. They call it mamaliga here.
Yes.
And this is sugar.
Sugar, yeah.
And that's rice, spaghetti. Everybody knows what that is. And you said, what do you do that for? Because we love the folks and we want to show them the love of Christ. And you know, people can hear the gospel a lot better when they have a little food in their stomach.
And I'm this is flour, plain flour.
And then with each one of them, each package, we give them a Bible, a little New Testament, and also a tremendous gospel message about Golgotha, okay? Golgotha. I don't know how you say it in English anymore. Calvary, okay? And we teach them a gospel message in here. And the reason we give food to these families, some of the families come, they don't know the Lord, do they? Some
no,
of the parents.
No, they don't. And actually, Martin, if I can say something.
Sure.
As we were out there, a mother of a woman who has the children, and the children come to us when we go there and we make the short program with the kids, said, it's okay if you don't give me any food. If you give me the New Testament and the book, I'll be happy just with that. And we're like, you know what, just take the whole bag, take the New Testament. We were happy.
You see, God said, man shall not live by bread alone. This is what you make bread with. This is a flour, right? This one. That one. That's the flour.
Yeah.
But by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. And so we have the privilege of winning these people to Christ. That's what it's all about. Winning them to Christ, letting them know the Lord Jesus personally, and then establishing and planting a New Testament church where they can be fed and they can grow in Christ. Amen. This is the heartbeat of the Lord Jesus. And some of you have caught the vision and some of you are with us on it, on making this possible. Now we're going to show you some pictures. And first, Bianca, tell them about the van that you took. How many packages did you take with you?
Like I said earlier, there were 130 packages that we put in the van. And then some brothers from Monasteria in Călăraș helped us to pack. And everything went quite quickly, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, some of the building that y'all went into, that's the new school building, isn't it? That's the
it
new
is, yeah.
We got to have for the after school and school. And you know what? Thank the Lord. We have a brother who is a professional teacher in the Bible school here, one of the Bible schools, a Christian Bible school. And his name is Brother Gabi Iancu. So I want you to pray for him that he could work with us. He wants to go down and work with us. But he's got all the credentials and everything we need for even the kids to have a license school if we need it, you know. So we'll see how it goes. But boy, when I heard that he wants to work with us, I invited him. What a blessing it is. So pray with us about that. Now, you'll see the building. You'll see inside this room here behind us. This is the room that they took all the packages in. And there's Brother Costica and Brother Nelu's there, and Brother Fani's there. Some of our dear brothers that work in the church, are leaders of the church down there. And I think this week they're having a baptism. They called me and said, Brother Martin, we're going to have a baptism this week. I said, I'm not coming because I try to stay away from the villages a lot because they have had some of that coronavirus going around in some of the places. Now where they're going to there, to baptize, they'll be wearing masks and they won't be hugging each other. But I want you to tell you that we're so grateful here in Romania. Just to be able to make another tape, huh, Bianca? And get back and talk to them. Sure does. So if there's any questions about what's going on, the churches are growing. They're still having people come. Like I say, we have two getting baptized this Sunday. And pray for us as the Lord opens the doors to go in these other places. It's not completely wide open like you know in America, but I think the how many was that? 771 people yesterday. I told Brother Dennis Maples this. He lives in Sevierville, Tennessee. I said, Brother, we have 771 people in Romania that have contracted this virus. He said 770. Well, he said, man, we got that much in our county, just in their little county. It's a Sevier County there. So pray for us as we go on with the Lord and push forward. Thank you so very, very much. Now, we want to give you the address that you can get in touch with us, and a mailing address where you can send us a gift if the Lord leads you to. We thank you so very much. Anything else you'd like to say, Bianca?
I just want to say thank you, because with so little money, we could do so much for so many people, so many families.
Tell them how much we pay for this packages.
Not even $500.
Yeah, not even $500.
Not even $500.
And how many families?
130.
130 families.
Yeah.
Now that's not, you say, well, that's not much. Listen, for them, it's a much. They're so grateful. A bag of sugar and rice and flour. I tell you what, as I talk about, my heart gets so full. Oil and the corn flour that we give them, cornmeal. And look here, spaghetti. And the Bible, the Word of God. So God bless you and thank you.
Thank you so much.